Today we'll see the nil collisioning operator in the Swift. We'll see what is a nil collisioning operator, what is the use of nil collisioning operator. See here, if you keep two question marks, that is called the nil collisioning operator. The main use of the nil collisioning operator is you can get the unwrapped value, not value, unwrapped value from the optional. That is the use of the nil collisioning operator. You can get the unwrapped value from the optionals. We have so many data access techniques also are there. This is the post unwrapping. You could keep the question mark, that is the post unwrapping. And if let, that is called the optional binding, and a guard let. Avoiding these three techniques, we can use the nil collisioning operator. If optional having a value, it will give the unwrapped value. If optional doesn't have the value, means that optional has a nil value, it gives the default value. That is also given by the user. Very simple. If you keep the optional and space, keep the two question marks, after that you need to give the default value. The main use of the nil collisioning operator is you can get the value from the optionals without using the force unwrapping, optional binding, and a guardless statement. Okay, we'll see in the output, we'll get clearly. This is the introduction. I'm declaring the I'm declaring one optional variable. I am declaring the name. I am declaring the string data type. Keep in the question mark, this is called the optional variable, and I am initializing the value is Vikrant. But if you print this, what is the value? You'll get the value is optional Vikrant. But I don't want to use the optional, I don't want to use a value optional Vikrant. I need only Vikrant, but it is not possible printing like this. For getting that this Vikrant value, previously we used the force unwrapping technique and optional binding technique and guardlet also. But avoiding these things, we are using the nil collisioning operator. This is very simple. This is the optional variable, keep to question mark, and it can give the, this is the default value. If optional has a value, it is having a value right now, so it will give the value. If doesn't have the value, it will take the default value. That's it. That is the use of, that is the power of the nil collisioning operator. Vikrant. To easily unwrap the value from the optionals without having any issues. Here we'll get Vikrant. For example, I am updating the value with the nil. It is possible because of name is a optional variable, so you can update it. Optional, so this is a optional, so it will take the nil value. This is a variable, so we are updating the value. Here initialize the value, here updating the value. Okay. Now again I am printing the statement. I am using the statement again, nil collisioning operator. We'll see what is output. What is output here and what is output here. We'll see the, it is a having a value. Look at here. So it will give the unwrapped value. Not a problem. But here we'll execute it. What is having the is this name has a nil value, so it doesn't have the value. So it will take that default value. What is the output now? Wiki. Okay, that is the beauty and that is the power of the nil collisioning operator. Okay. And I would like to use the, instead of string, I am using the 404. Is it possible? It is a possible because of we declare that as a string variable. So no need to use here also a string string literal. You can use the integer literal also, or integer data also, or the exact word is integer literal. This is string literal. Okay, we'll check it out. What is the output here? Vikrant. Here is a, this is a nil, so here will be the wiki. Here is, this is also a nil value, so it will give the 404. That means that if it is a, it is having the value, it will give the unwrapped value. If doesn't have the value, if it is having a nil value, it will give the default value. Default value is your wish, you can give the any value, no problem. Okay, that is about nil collision operator. If you do like, please subscribe and share it and like it. Thank you very much.